enough to, like I say, I'm not always the most qualified person. I just happen to be friends with him, but we have a long history. We've done a lot of his books. We did Worlds of Amano. We did Shinjuku. You guys might know the Final Fantasy box set called In the Sky, which is one of my favorite things of all time. We did Dawn. We published Vampire Hunter D, which is the best-selling light novel in the English language, actually. And Amano Sensei, of course, does the art for that. What are you working on? Since they've none of you on that.
Which was the mic in the time?
Like,
I know.
Marcus. He's riding a horse, apparently, he says. Let's see how it comes. So sometimes they have these live drawings, and this is actually not common to him. But they did one, so it was 20 meters wide, so about 60 feet wide. They did it in an hour. その後、相当隅が汚かったじゃないか。真っ黒だった。So yeah, basically it's like churning butter in a big bucket full of the ink, and use something akin to maybe a mop or a broom, and was walking along with it, and just was completely soaked in ink from head to foot. Like, in 1 hour, he did that. And he finished. And that was for the background of like a stage play. No, they had some of the ink sets, so he did a background for a stage play, and it basically became the wraparound. And when he drew, that time he also drew a horse, but she says interestingly, drew it from the hoof first, so no one had any idea what was being drawn. Here it's kind of materialized from the head, but it started as a hoof, and everyone was sort of, what's going on here? What is he going to draw? And it wound up being a horse. It's cool. So he had a recently there was some work that they wanted him to do Odin for Final Fantasy, and he was thinking, gosh, what should I draw? He needed some inspiration for Odin for some of the work that had come in, and so they Googled it just to get some inspiration, and the first thing that showed up was Amano's work. So and he's like, I can't use this, you know. It's like a
game. だからあのゲームのキャラクターっていうのは結構神話から取ってるんですよ。実際のね、それは北欧神話なんですけども、あとギリシャ神話とか、だからゲームってやっぱり神話なのかなっていう気がしますね。
See, games for him are mythos, they're mythology for him, and I think that's a lot of we've seen the effect of that, where he's not really just doing characters, but from the characters spring forth the world from which they were birthed. So rather than just draw characters as characters themselves,he makes sure that they feel like they're all grounded in some sort of mythos that might reasonably exist. So, Baphomet, the character everyone in Japan, that's a dragon in Japan. But in actual Grecian mythology, it has the head of a goat, I believe, and scales. But Amano Sensei drew it as sort of this mechanized dragon. And now in Japanese, in just regular Japanese culture, whenever Baphomet is mentioned, they all think it's a dragon because of that influence. No one's really aware of where it came from. But apparently Amano Sensei, his work has influenced it such that it's actually changed the flow of culture and of words, I guess, too. And apparently it's on Wikipedia, so you know you can trust it. It was weird. This is a really weird. So we're not saying any names of any people, but so there's sort of the red light district called Yoshiwara in Japan. And Amano Sensei, when he was just developing or sort of getting his foot in the door, his studio was not in the nicest area, so it was kind of the red light district. And from a certain studio, a person would always come and get the art, so they'd show up at his place, he'd have the art, and he'd hand it to them. And one time the person showed up, and it's kind of like the bathhouse district, or I don't know how to describe it, but they showed up and their hair was wet, and he's like, huh, it's not raining, and handed them the art, and the guy left. So, infer what you want, so there you go. It's okay. Yeah, we have to be careful when we talk about it here. You know, he's the guardian of many secrets, apparently. Yeah, there's also, I think you guys might know, there was an autograph session yesterday. It's ticketed, but there's one from tomorrow from 1:30 to 2:30 as well.
では、何時頃？お、大丈夫です。大丈夫、万事会長。 写真はない。
大丈夫。
ここは神話。
え？
ここは神話。日本の絵。
And actually, there's some mythological books, so like in mythological encyclopedias, and in Japan, oftentimes when there is a piece of mythos from either Greek or Roman gods, whatever, they ask Kamado Sensei to do those paintings. Because there's no actual pictures of them, so they figure he probably has a good idea. And, you know, this is where we're talking about how art can spring forth from different media. Uematsu-san's songs are listed in Japanese textbooks. So, again, if you don't know it as the theme song of Final Fantasy, you might know it from some of the river means. And actually, one that I thought was interesting that Amano-sensei mentioned earlier was the use of the Sailor Moon theme song during ice skating in the Olympics. So you might not have ever seen Sailor Moon or heard of it, but if you watch the ice skating event, you might say, hey, that's a great song. So really, it doesn't matter how the medium by which it arrives at the masses, but just that it does. There was a picture, it was I can't remember the actual name of the painting, it's in many of the books, the Final Fantasy books, and it's a picture of a town that Amano did. And the actual painting is something like 6 or 7 meters wide, but it's incredibly detailed. And the interviewer asked, how long did it take you to do this? And Amano said, one day. And she's like, one day? And the interesting thing was that he'd actually done three separate illustrations, but only used one. So he does tend to sketch quick. If any of you have ever been in a signing with him, he'll sometimes draw the person's face in a matter of like 15 seconds. So as you can tell now, doing this in 15 minutes is, it's no exaggeration that he works quite quickly. So guys, here you are.